Yo, what's up, guys? Insane Game Freak here to bring you another Pokemon Best Wishes episode review. Be perfectly honest, I didn't put this on my fan page on my Facebook. I did put this on my personal page. I have been quote unquote sick with a stomach virus since I believe last night, it was actually ironically after I got through watching my, standard episodes and finishing some stuff. I got this horrible stomach virus just came at me and fucked me up. I've thrown up like 3 times within the last like 18 hours or some shit. But I said I want to watch the next episode of Pokemon. And for people who don't know, my rule with Pokemon episodes is that I always want to watch. I'll review an episode after I watch it before I go to the next one. So, for the sake of that, that's all I'm gonna do. I'm still out of it. I mean, I've been taking Tylenol, Pedialyte, and fucking nausea medicine. Thrown up like 3 times. And just so you know, throwing up is painful as hell. For those who haven't done it in a while, and I haven't done it in a while, it's like your body trying to choke the shit out of you. It's not fun. But anyways, I'm starting to look at the camera. I'm still kind of out of it. I'm not like well. I'm just. I figured I'd go ahead and talk about it. The episode itself, I was actually surprised, was actually pretty well done. I forget Patrat's evolution's name in English. I want to say Warhog or Warhog, but I don't think that's right. I actually did like him. I like Patrat's evolution's little development. I like N's development. Pretty much, it seems like if the fillers are like this, where they kind of develop N's character, I'm not going to really mind the fillers. Because if you're developing a character, it works out for me. But once again, I'm thinking the fear is going to be, we're not going to do anything for Ash's character. We're just going to keep fucking doing this shit for N's character, which makes Ash feel really flat as a character. Especially when you compare him to N, who's getting all this development. He's even starting to change calling from Pokemon Friends to Pokemon, which ironically, I feel like Friends is a more respectable term than Pokemon. I'm not totally sure if that has, but, they're showing subtle hints in his change. Fuck Team Rocket, they're irrelevant. The Rescue Squad thing was cool. Hiroto and fucking In arguing period was interesting because it gives those filler characters a more of a purpose, not just there to, deviate from time for like 20, 30 minutes until the next episode that's really relevant comes in. Because, we're seeing In's development, how he's changing through the interactions he's making with different people. Because the whole thing was, he didn't think Pokemon should risk their lives to save humans. Because that doesn't seem right to him. Like, he's kind of a Pokemon elitist, and he doesn't really realize it. But I do like that sense of development, so the episode was cool. I'll go ahead and talk about the Mewtwo stuff, or the Mewtwo's new form stuff, because that was revealed last night. And I didn't really get a chance to make a video because I started vomiting. It wasn't really fun. I don't know what all the hate is for that form. It looks actually pretty cool to me. It looks a lot better than what I thought it would look like. I didn't know they were doing a new form of Mewtwo. And it also means a lot of Gen 1 Pokemon are going to be in this game. Which I'm actually pretty happy about because it shows the game will have a level of versatility. And the fact that they're like pushing first gen again. Which is always interesting. So we have our two legendaries. Our three starters, and now we have Mewtwo's either evolution or form, but I'm pretty sure it's another form because to have it be an evolution wouldn't make any sense considering Mewtwo technically isn't a real Pokemon. He's a clone. He's just like a jacked up clone, but he's not like an official Pokemon technically. The anime's starting to look up, the games are starting to look cool, but as I said, the form looks pretty cool, and if you look at the trailer, you see him fight a whole bunch of fucking Gen 1, so at least this game will be a lot more balanced and not just be focusing on 6th gen, because it's not like Black and White 2 was Black and White or Black and White 2 were bad with that, but a lot of people who play the Pokemon games have been with it since at least Gen 1 or Gen 2, so it's cool to see those characters show up again. So in terms of the X and Y standpoint, shit looks like it's going to be pretty cool, and I don't have any problems with Mewtwo's new form. He's probably going to be in the next Smash Bros. Game. Just saying. Other than that, the next episode is Charizard's Return, which I'm kind of curious how they're going to do this in the dub, because from what I've seen, they're doing reanimation shots of Ash's history with Charizard. I'm also curious about whether when he remeets Charizard, is it going to be under the pretense that he's actually done with the training? That he's actually done, like, training with Liza in the Dragon Village and shit? Because if it is, that'd be fucking beast as hell. But the reason why I said how they're going to do the dub, because I don't know if they're going to reuse the Vorkius clips or just have Ash's current voice actor, just have new voice actors for the current cast. I mean, technically, they already have people for Brock, and I don't know about Misty, because I don't know if Misty has shown up since Pokemon USA took over. I don't think she has, so granted, that's implying she talks in the flashback, which I won't know until next week, but I'm actually surprised they reanimated shit. They rarely reanimate things for Pokemon flashbacks. They usually just use the same goddamn clip over and over again. The fact that they're actually reanimating it looks cool as fuck. And from what I've seen from the clips, it looks like the clips look beast as shit. I even like the whole idea of the next episode being like a Kanto fair. Also, the obvious Dragonite versus Charizard. Son, I hope this is a beast-ass fight because I'm expecting it to be. But I'm going to go lay down, watch some episodes, then probably watch Dexter and then try to get through Avatar because I told J-Man I would at least start it. So, yeah. Anyways, thank you guys for the support. Thank you guys for watching, commenting, and, you know, pushing these videos. This has been the Insane Game Freak. Like the game, play the win. Leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section below. And I'll catch you guys later. Peace. Oh, ow, that actually hurts. Oh, the throat. The vomiting and throat in your throat. Oh, that hurts. Anyways, peace.